So in 2019, we went to a site and established a couple of stations, namely benchmark 1 and benchmark 2. They're about 50 meters apart. And then we have also established another station, benchmark 3, which is about 1,100 meter away. So what we did, we put a G2 DGPS system on a benchmark 1 and did an observation for about 4 hours to find the mean position of benchmark 1. Then we took that same DGPS on benchmark 2 and did another 4 hours of observation. So we found these two coordinates very, very accurately. The coordinate accuracy was within 0.015 or better in terms of standard deviation. And then we put a total station on benchmark 1, took benchmark 2 as a RO, and then we established benchmark 3 by total station. We did not do any observation of G2 DGPS on benchmark 3. Now, what happened in 2022, 3 years later, the client has come back to us saying that the coordinates are not matching. They have done their own set of observation. They are asking that we do a resurvey because the coordinates they have observed and they are not matching. So they are taking benchmark 1 as the reference point for the RTK. Did an observation on benchmark 2, about 15 mm difference, and benchmark 3, about 30 centimeter difference, which is about 1.1 kilometer away. So what we did, we sent out a team again on the same benchmark 1. We put a G2 DGPS exactly, and we put a G2 DGPS on benchmark 2, and we did a set of observation. And what we found, let me draw that for you. We found the position of benchmark 1 here and benchmark 2 here. Okay. So this distance was about 18 centimeter at 045 degree. Okay. And that was the difference I was getting. And then we found this distance to be about 13 centimeter at 050 degree. So we can clearly see that both the station has shifted by about 13 to 15, 18 centimeter at approximately northeast direction. You might have seen one of my previous video on the IGS stations, and we discussed that the Indian continent is drifting a minimum of 4 centimeter and a maximum of 17 centimeter per year towards north-northeast every year. Minimum is 4 centimeter and maximum is 17 centimeter every year. So from 2019 to 2022, the difference is about 3 years. Even at a 4 centimeter movement every year, a 12 centimeter movement towards north-northeast is expected. And that's what we actually see from here, 18 centimeter towards northeast and 13 centimeter towards northeast. Now for a client, this is a big problem. The client is asking us which one is right. The 2019 observation was right, or 2022 observation was right. Now, as a surveyor, both my observations during 2019 and 2022, both are right. There is nothing wrong in 2019 observation. The 2019 observation was done with a particular set of DGPS for a 4 hours of observation, and we found a standard deviation of 0.015. Okay, that's about 15 mm standard deviation. It means my position is very, very accurate, and the same with the benchmark 2. Now we did the same observation again, and we again found a position with a better standard deviation, you know, maybe 10 mm with a standard deviation, which is in a surveying field is considered to be very accurate. So there is nothing wrong in one set of observation in 2019 and another set of observation in 2022. So how do you explain it to the client? How client can move ahead with this kind of a observation and do the construction? Well, to start with, and everybody has to accept that there is a tectonic plate movement, and the station that was established 3 years back is going to be shifted at a minimum of 4 centimeters per year speed. The main thing is that as a surveyor, you are going to do the survey, you must know the criteria the client is looking at. Now the client is coming back to us saying that they want a 5 mm accuracy. Okay, you cannot have a 5 mm accuracy with a G2 DGPS, you know, a standalone position. You can only have a standard deviation of your position. So you have to know what the client wants, and you have to advise the client accordingly. So I hope you understand the problem of what a surveyor faces in the field, and how you can talk to the client and make him understand the issues that we do survey on the ground, and how we do the survey, what are the accuracies, what are the standard deviation. If I make a ground control station today in 2022, that ground control station will not be the same in 2030. In 8 years, it would have moved by at least 30-35 centimeters. So we have to understand that client is not going to understand. They are paying us money to get the position as accurate as possible. It's our job to talk to the client, to make him understand the what could be the issue. So what is the best way to do an observation where no other reference station or nothing exists and you are going to establish a brand new ground control point? First, you do a GNSS mission planning to know about the availability of the satellites and also find out the PDOPs. Once you have your mission planning, go and establish your station and put on your GNSS device and carry out minimum of 4 hours of mean position, and at the same time you carry out a 4 hours of simultaneous Rhinex observation. So you have two sets of data. One is your mean position, another one is your Rhinex position. So one set of data is a backup of another set of data. So next, I suggest after 8 to 10 hours, you carry out again the same observation. I suggest do not remove your antenna or the equipment so that your antenna is exactly in the same position for both sets of observation. So what happens if you do a second set of observation 8 to 10 hours later? You have a repeatability option. You know, with you can say that I have done this observation 2 times and you have a repeatability. So that is very important. You have 2 sets of data, mean position and Rhinex, and a repeatability. I hope this small case study is a good deviation from the standard videos that I make. I'm waiting for any of your comments, any suggestion that you might want to make. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and keep watching. Thanks for being here today.